What's good, son? It's your boy Roswell here, coming at y'all with a trading video. And today, I'm gonna teach y'all how to make millions of coins through investing in Team of the Week players. Now you can see, this is Team of the Week number 2. I didn't do Team of the Week 1, as this is gonna be a series of each week. I'll be showing you guys trading tips and ways to make millions of coins. But with Team of the Week 1, the game was only out for one day. You know, it's hard to accumulate coins to be able to get those players right away. So basically, while you're looking at this Team of the Week, every week, you're going to want to make a list of which players you think are the best that you see. Obviously, in this week, there's Messi and Aubameyang. But as this is Team of the Week 2, you may not have many coins as I do right here. You know, still got some FIFA points left, you know. But you don't have many coins, you can't be affording those players. And so, basically, we're going to want to start low or like in the mid-level, as later on you'll get more coins. So basically here as we look, you got some nice cards that, you know, they may be like 200k or something like that, like as for the Quetta, that's a very good one right there. I would say this is the best player to invest in the Team of the Week, which I'm going to show y'all in a second. You got Morata, who's very good as well, and Pjanic. Those are the three ones that we'll probably be looking at the most. So basically, we're going to check their price right now. We're going to check Aspilicueta's price. Make sure it's on special. Ain't gonna look at his card. As you see right now, he's going for 180, 190k, 175 right there, around that range. Right now, that's way too expensive because they just came out. So you're not gonna be buying this card right away. You're gonna be waiting. You know, they're on Friday, the one to watch comes out. So you're gonna be waiting till maybe Sunday or Monday. Maybe they got some special packs out. That's when you're gonna try, if you got the coins, to buy one or two of these cards. And basically what you do, you wait a couple weeks, maybe 2-3 weeks, and you go ahead and you sell them on. If you made enough profit, you're happy with the profit. Basically, you don't sell until you're happy with your profit. Out here, we don't take losses. If you lose coins on him, keep them. Soon enough, he'll go up. But you just gotta be wary if the player gets another Team of the Week. Because, say, for example, a risky player would be Morata. I did say earlier that he's a good investment, but he's a player that scores goals. Goals get you informed most of the time. You know, sometimes the EA not actually looking how the player plays, and they decide, oh, he scored 2-3 goals. Obviously, that's a good performance, but, you know, they skip some players out because they didn't score, but they had a good performance. Morata's a guy who scores a lot of goals, so he might get an 87 informed, you know, maybe 4 weeks from now. No bueno. This card's gonna go down, you're gonna lose coins. Basically, you always gotta be on watch for that. Yeah, but basically, you wanna look at these players. You know, there's also a Shawawi. You wanna check their prices every once in a while. You know, check FUTBIN. I don't think FUTBIN is up right now, but once FUTBIN is up, you wanna be checking their prices, checking the graph, the little graph they got on FUTBIN. I'll probably put a picture in for that. And yeah, that's basically what you gotta do. So we gonna look at a few players. I know we just looked at Aspilicueta. He's 170k. So maybe you hope by like Sunday he'll be near 100k because of all those packs are gonna come out on Friday with the full game release and with the one to watch is coming out. So for example, El Shawawi, I'm a guess right now he's probably like 70k. Okay, he's 50k. See, that's super cheap already. If this man ever hits 30-20k, that's too cheap for El Shawawi. He got 5-star skill moves. Yeah, he got 2-star weak foot. Happens. I think he used to have 3 or 4. But I guess they downgraded him this year. But those stats are too good if he ever hits 30k. Because as more packs come out, more people will pack him. He'll get cheaper. That's bueno. That's good. And if he hits 30k, you're going to buy a few. This is probably a more easy option because he's a lot cheaper, you know. Spend a few points, you get those coins up maybe to 100k, 150k, you can get 2 or 3 of them when the time comes. And so basically, once they go out of packs, you know, for example, let's say Team of the Week 1. Where it at? My bad. Team of the Week. Go ahead and look at Team of the Week 1. Let's look at some of these players. Team of the Week. This is the week that I didn't do, you don't have the coins. But if you were able to invest in these, you would have made bank. Player like Fakambu. Let's go and check him out. Before he went out of packs, he was going for like 40k. 40, 50k. He's already in the 60s. People are bidding 68, 500. you're already making bank. Another good player is Valencia. If you're able to get Valencia, you would have made 100,000 or something like that. Look, he's 175 right now. That's expensive. It's going to take him a while to go up because he's an expensive player. But in 2, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, they're going to be rare. Same with Team of the Week 2. This is something key for Team of the Week 2. I'll go ahead and show you right now. Because these players, the game, the full game, if you didn't get the Ronaldo edition or the Icon edition, it don't come out till Friday. So that's 3 days. Only a select amount of people will be able to pack them. And you know how EA with their bullshit packs, it's hard to pack them, bro. You're gonna want to get, you know, you're not going to get them all the time in every pack. You're going to get some non-rares, no flares coming out, no billboard, nothing like that. You're just going to get nothing. But for the few people who pack them, it'll be good. So basically, yeah. So the three players that you're going to want, I'd say you go for, maybe four, include El Shaarawy, Morata, El Shaarawy, Pjanic, and Azpilicueta. You're going to want to check these players' prices throughout the week. Look for a time where you see a big dip in price. Pick them up. Pick two or three up. I think it'll be Sunday or Monday. You know, I wouldn't do it on Friday because that's when the packs just come out. And it's not like there's going to come out for a whole week. Yeah. And basically, the biggest trick to this is that you're going to want to beat the hype. Beat the hype. Because there's a time where there's a bunch of investors who are doing this all the time. I'm not the only one. I didn't come up with this. There's a bunch of investors. If you beat the hype, you're going to make a lot of coins. Because there's a time where everybody just starts buying them. They're like, oh, this is the time to invest. You miss it. You miss the train. It's done. You don't want to touch the influence no more. And yeah. So basically, that's what you do. You just keep checking the prices. Pjanic, 144, that's a little too expensive, right? There's 100 right there, but that's just a bit. 120, okay, it's getting better. Maybe you'll hope. I hope Pjanic hits 80K. You see him hit 80K, and it's Sunday, you see him hit 80K, go ahead, pick him up. And you just want to, you know, put him in the team, keep him for 3 weeks. I know coins are a little short because the game just came out, but you keep him in the team 3 weeks. You say, damn, I don't like this team, or damn, Pjanic went up 40K, sell him. You make your coins, you invest in the next team. And yeah, that's basically it. This is the video, man. Check me out on Twitter at RoswellRoss639. I'll be leaving all my Twitch and everything in the description. And I'm out. I'm a real prince.